You know the story. A menacing android hunts down a group of humans in a post-apocalyptic wasteland to deny them healthcare coverage. And alright, maybe that's not the premise for a sci-fi blockbuster, but as far as worrying about artificial intelligence goes, real-life dangers like that are probably more concerning than what's in the movies. While Hollywood often depicts the threat of AI as machines that have gained consciousness, just what do you think you're doing, Dave? That day may or may not ever come. But AI-powered machines already make an alarming number of decisions for us, from driving our cars to piloting military drones and selecting targets on the battlefield. And according to the people who study it, AI doesn't need to be self-aware to be dangerous. If you are worried about the machine uprising, we've got good news. While AI systems are becoming more powerful every day, there's no evidence that they're becoming conscious. But I also have some bad news. There are a lot of other ways AI can go horribly wrong, and it kind of already has. So let's start with what happens when AI is fed bad data. In 2019, the healthcare company Optum was using an AI-powered algorithm they built to predict which patients would benefit from extra medical care. You know, the kind of thing that might save some lives. That algorithm selected people with higher predicted medical expenses for extra healthcare assistance, and it was developed using past insurance claims data, previous diagnoses and procedures, and patient demographics like age and sex. So it sounds like a good idea to make informed decisions based on previous data, but this algorithm wound up discriminating against Black patients, leading them to miss out on healthcare they needed. A 2019 study published in the journal Science found that Optum's algorithm was massively under-predicting the health risks for Black patients compared to white patients. The algorithm gave a Black person and a white person the same predicted risk score, even though the Black person was more likely to have worse actual health and be in greater need. Now, before you get out your pitchforks, technically there was nothing racist about the algorithm itself. The weird thing about this result is that race was not included in the demographics that Optum's algorithm ran through at all. It turned out the problem was the data they fed their algorithm. That data was related to how much money had previously been spent on a person's care, not a pure measure of their physical health. And historically, inequality and discrimination have led to an imbalance in how money has been spent on different groups. Which means if you try and predict healthcare needs based on past healthcare expenses, you'll naturally wind up discriminating against Black patients. So the data going into their algorithm wasn't ever going to address their goal. And this kind of problem goes beyond healthcare. Any AI can fail if its data aren't representative, fair, accurate, and reliable. In cases like this, AI tools aren't entirely to blame for the mayhem that ensues. But deciding whether you can blame them can be a much bigger problem. Under all the slick interfaces, AI tools are really a big old tangle of mathematical functions and parameters that scientists call models, because they model how an outcome or decision depends on the data. Even when those models seem to work, understanding why they work is a whole other story. In the good old days, statistical models were often based on straightforward assumptions about how different data depended on each other. For instance, you can fit a straight line through the middle of a bunch of data points to predict something like a student's expected grade based on their attendance. This kind of linear model is still incredibly useful. The parameters that define the model, like the slope of the line, are learned from the data. For stats geeks, this is where the good stuff is. By looking at the parameters, like the slope of that line, you can say in plain English, this is exactly how much we expect a student's grade to increase for every extra day they attend. So in simple cases, the parameters directly tell us about what assumptions the model is making, about the relationship between attendance and grades, and importantly, whether those assumptions are reasonable. But modern AI tools are developed with way more complicated models. Maybe you've heard of deep learning, the kind of fancy algorithms that lurk behind pretty much all modern AI. The deep refers to the huge number of layers of mathematical functions whose outputs become the input for the next layer. It's line graphs all the way down. And in an algorithmic lasagna with billions of parameters, there's no airtight way of saying the algorithm thinks this picture is a cat because of its cute fuzzy face, pointy ears, and tail. The parameters are basically impossible to understand in the same way. Researchers often call this the black box problem, since unlike a linear model, we can't easily peek inside and see what's really going on. That's big trouble, because one of the main reasons for creating AI is to automate complex tasks where we can't simply program every possible response, like driving a car, for example. And if we don't know why an AI is making the prediction it does in those situations, it becomes much harder to hold it accountable, rely on it, or fix it. And that's what the ride-sharing company Uber found out with their self-driving cars. They modified them with all kinds of sophisticated sensors, from cameras to radar to its laser-based cousin, LiDAR. The idea was to detect every object within a certain distance of the car, like other cars, pedestrians, cyclists, and that way it could respond appropriately. But there weren't any concrete rules the algorithm had for how it identified certain objects, just very complicated pattern matching from the data. And when we don't understand what those patterns are or how they're used inside the black box, things can go wrong fast. In March 2018, while a self-driving Uber car was moving around Arizona at night, it struck and killed Elaine Herzberg, a pedestrian who had been crossing the road. After the event, a report by the National Transport Safety Board found that the sensors detected Elaine in enough time to prevent collision, but the algorithm kept changing its prediction of what she was from vehicle to bicycle to other object, making it harder for the AI to determine that the car needed to stop. So how badly did the AI mess up? Well, humans driving on a dark night might also struggle with identifying whether that blob in the distance is a person, but at least a human driver could explain their decision. Even though we can peer into every element of an AI model down to the last parameter, it's much harder to understand why it failed to stop. All of this points to the big danger of the black box problem. When an AI behaves in odd and unpredictable ways, it's not always possible to understand the logic behind it. Without that sort of understanding, it's much harder to know when we can hand off duties to an AI safely. Uber and other companies claim to have improved their modeling since 2018, but a lot of the models AI scientists evaluate still make these sorts of mistakes today. And we're not much closer to explaining how AI models like these work than we were back then. So we're in a kind of limbo between making the most sophisticated algorithms and keeping them comprehensible for the humans who need to hold them accountable. And accountability is super important for AI tools because they're also prone to acting in ways that can seem completely bizarre if we don't know what they're thinking. In 2017, Facebook was experimenting with chatbots trained to negotiate with each other over virtual items worth different points, saying things like, "I want the books and the hats, and you get the ball." And for the most part, they did pretty well. They came up with strategies much like humans, such as driving a hard bargain or even lying about what they really wanted. But things got weird. Instead of using grammatically correct English, the language the models were trained in, they occasionally started saying stuff like, "I can, I, everything else." And balls have zero to me. And that sounds like the coding bug of the century. But the kicker is, after exchanging nonsense like this, the two AIs would sometimes complete a successful deal. What seems to have happened is that despite setting a clear goal, negotiate to get what you want using English words, sometimes the approach taken by the AI looked nothing like what we might expect, even though it did technically achieve the outcome. And because of our arch nemesis, the black box problem, we can't exactly look in and work out what the made-up language of the AI really means. Researchers call this problem goal misalignment. You can give an AI an objective, but with enough flexibility, the way it achieves that objective might seem completely alien and sometimes go catastrophically wrong. For example, the Securities and Exchange Commission found that a 2010 stock market crash that caused a total temporary loss of $1 trillion in market value was caused by an algorithm tasked with executing a bunch of sales. That was in large part because the algorithm focused only on how much of the asset it sold without paying attention to its price or the timescales it was trying to sell the stock for, creating chaos in the markets. As AI gets more sophisticated and takes over more financial trading from humans, the risk of them executing wild strategies in pursuit of their goals risks wild tailspins in the market. And finance isn't the only industry affected by this problem. In 2011, a company you might have heard of called YouTube sent out an internal memo stating that the company's main goal was to maximize watch time. That's the amount of time people stick around for when they're watching videos based on YouTube's recommendation algorithm. It probably worked, since a few years later they achieved the goal of having 1 billion hours of watch time on the platform in a single day. But not everyone would call it a success. A former AI engineer at Google came out in 2018 to say that one side effect was the algorithm pushing more conspiracy theory videos on people. Yikes. I guess nothing keeps you watching YouTube like getting convinced that the rest of the media is lying. Now, all of that is pretty terrifying, but it can be explained by Goodhart's law, which says that if you make something you're measuring an explicit target, it stops being a good measure. Giving an algorithm a simple goal like increase watch time and optimizing solely for that without taking other factors into account can conflict with important goals like keep the platform safe and don't stoke a political fire. Wherever AI is used in complex environments, goal misalignment and Goodhart's law are always lurking. Just telling an AI tool what outcome you want to achieve doesn't mean it'll go about it in the way that you think or even want. If we aren't careful about exactly what problem we're trying to solve, even the best data and algorithms could destabilize our politics, the economy, and maybe even our access to food as turbocharged AI enters the world of farming. The good news is that even if we can't look into the black box, these algorithms are changeable. A 2024 study in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science showed that YouTube's algorithm can be retrained to provide better recommendations over a month of thoughtful choices in what you watch. But that's the thing. It requires being thoughtful about how we engage with AI and about how we evaluate it. And speaking of being thoughtful, it's time to consider the scariest application of AI, autonomous weapons. I'm talking drones mounted with guns that can identify and eliminate targets all on their own. And by targets, I mean buildings and people. As one 2023 study points out, pretty much all of the major world powers are developing these weapons. And as autonomous drones become a warfare reality, the idea of having a swarm of drones that can coordinate an attack seems to be on everyone's minds. On top of the issues with data, interpretability, and alignment, something lots of researchers worry about is the lack of information on how well autonomous weapons systems work. Military ops are famously covert. As a 2021 report from the United Nations Institute for Disarmament Research points out, there isn't a whole lot of public data analysis or research on AI weapon capabilities. And unlike YouTube views or driving a car, it's not exactly possible to go out and collect a bunch of real-world data on how easily a swarm of AI drones can distinguish between a combatant or a civilian in live combat situations. The data used to test the system might not reflect the situations it has to face in reality. Like, the environment could change, humans could exploit and fool unknown flaws in the model, or an unexpected earthquake could throw off the entire navigational system. As the report puts it, autonomous system failures are infinitely possible, in a certain sense, inevitable. So, great. Real-world evaluation is super important when we can't look into the mind of an AI tool and make sure it really understands what it's dealing with. And if the AI isn't aligned in the way we want it to be, it's harder to trust its behavior when the stakes are high. This is bad for both the army and individual soldiers alike. A 2018 study in the Journal of Military Ethics points out that these flaws stop soldiers from relying on these weapons on the battlefield, unlike the squad mates they've built trust with. The concern is so great that a treaty to ban lethal autonomous weapons without human oversight is being considered by the United Nations, with more than 100 countries in support. Now, I know this video has covered some things that could keep a person up at night, but we can't ban all AI any more than we can ban a straight line through data on a graph. And few people want to, because it's revolutionizing parts of healthcare, drug discovery, environmental monitoring, public services, and more for the better. What many AI researchers are calling for is more oversight. In addition to supporting treaties and regulation, they're pushing for corporations to prove their systems are safe before releasing them. You know, the same thing we require of companies in other industries, like autopilot software in aviation. In other words, they're saying we all need to be conscious of the risks AI poses, whether it is or not. Thank you to the Future of Life Institute for supporting this SciShow video. FLI is a global nonprofit that aims to steer advanced technologies towards benefiting humanity. One of those is, unsurprisingly, artificial intelligence. So if you'd like to learn more, please visit futureoflife.org/safety.